Hello and assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Alumni Success Story Show Replug. My name is Muhammad Ali Azaz and I am Head of Alumni Relations at University of Central Punjab. With us today we have a very distinguished alumni of class of 2012. Her name is Ms. Maira Zamir Syed. She's currently working with the World Bank. Welcome, Maira, on the show.
Thank you, Ali. Thank you for inviting me.
You're welcome. You're welcome. So can you tell us about your role at the World Bank?
Sure. So currently, I am a Gender and Social Development Analyst at the World Bank headquarters in Washington, D.C. I started earlier with managing the regional gender portfolio in South Asia, where every World Bank project has to go to a process called gender tag, and I used to manage all that portfolio. But now I switched to the energy sector because I believe more women need to be in the energy sector, especially in the South Asian countries. So right now I'm working with a platform called WePower, which is Women in the Power Sector, and we are working with all the public utilities, the private sector organizations that participates in the power and electricity generation in South Asian countries. For example, in Pakistan, we are working with WAPTA, with LESCO, with ISCO, and non-profits such as Women Engineering Pakistan, Women in Energy. And they are doing amazing jobs in bringing more women into the STEM outreach education, and then also recruitment, professional development, retention, and also at the policy and institutional level chain. So I think WePower is making a great difference in bringing more women into the power sector and also promoting them to go to the leadership position. So it's not only just the participation, but the recognition and retention as well.
Great, that is so progressive. So how do you feel to be back at UCP?
It's amazing. I mean, I feel like coming back to my second home, spending 4 years here, you know, I miss my professors, I miss my fellow students, and you know, it feels like going back to the same place, like you come back to your home. So I appreciate that you know, invited me here, and I'm so happy to be here.
Great. So Maira, what about your early education? From where did you get your early education?
So this is a very surprising thing, that I could not attend school until I was 12 years old, because we were living in a very small town in Saudi Arabia. And you know, I was homeschooled until I was 12. And then I came back to Pakistan and I joined school here straight from the ninth, you know, grade. And then, of course, you know, moving on, I graduated from an Ivy League institution. I did my Master of Public Administration, MPA from Cornell.
After University of Central Punjab, you went to Ivy League institution.
Right.
And that was on scholarship.
Yes. It's a Fulbright scholarship. That's mm-hmm. a very prestigious program of the United States Department. And of course, UCP contributed a lot. I mean, how could I get there, you know, without UCP? UCP offered me scholarship and opened its doors to me when everything was closed. And UCP opened its door to me, and here I am today.
That is really inspiring. That mm-hmm. is really inspiring. So moving to from UCP to an Ivy League university, what you did after that?
So after I graduated from Cornell, I started working at the United Nations headquarters in New York. And I was working with Public Administration and Development Management Institute. There, you know, I realized that I need to go back to Pakistan and work in the development sector. So I came back to Pakistan, and then I joined Planning Commission, which is Ministry of Planning, Development and Reforms at that time, and I worked directly with the federal minister. We worked on various projects surrounding, you know, poverty reduction, social development, and also projects in Balochistan, in KP, in Fatah, where I realized that, you know, I just want to work for women empowerment, because women there, you know, they suffer from so many issues, for example, restricted mobility, maternal health issues, and inequality in general at households. So I realized that this is something I want to do for the rest of my life.
So did you visit any other country or a place for women empowerment cause?
Yes, I did visited so many countries, and I'm fortunate that Cornell itself, you know, sponsored a lot of projects. One project that I want to mention here is the project I worked in Uganda and Rwanda with women child soldiers. Besides, I also went to Thailand to work with women rice farmers, and also in South Korea generally to work on public administration policies and do a comparative analysis about, you know, public administration system in the US, in Pakistan, in South Korea. So that was a good analogy and a mix to understand, you know, how public administration system works, you know, in different countries, in different contexts. And I did work on other projects too in different countries, for example, China, Costa Rica, and East Asia, and also Africa in general.
Great, that is very diverse. So what are your views that how did your studies or your stay at University of Central Punjab contributed in grooming of your personality?
I think a lot, Ali, because for example, when I came here, I was completely, you know, a very shy and very nerd student, and your professors, they help you to, you know, become more confident. So for example, at that time, just a single presentation in front of the class was a big deal for me. So you learn a lot, you know, you develop that confidence, you know, you present to your fellow students and, you know, your professor, and they appreciate you. There is always constructive feedback coming from the professors, which I appreciated so much, and a lot of support, you know, you feel. And then interacting with people from diverse backgrounds. So UCP is very diverse. There are students coming from different backgrounds, different, you know, cities, different provinces, and you learn a lot. So something I would recommend to students at the present is to connect more. For example, if I go back to my time, I would connect more and more to learn more. I wasn't a very active student in extracurricular activities, you know, I just used to, you know, go to classes, speak to my professors, do my projects, and then, you know, just go back to home. So I would, you know, recommend students to participate more so that, you know, you can learn more, you can learn from each other experiences and get to know your professors more. That is so important because they have amazing experiences, you know, they come from different backgrounds. I remember one of my professors, Dr. Bashir Ahmed, he went to University of Michigan, and, you know, he encouraged me so much that, you know, look at you, you know, you can do it, you know, you can go abroad by yourself and you can study. And of course, you know, I did take that step, and it's amazing, it's wonderful that what I experienced, you know, I felt like, you know, it's just like I came out of outside the box, and there where UCP helped me. So yes, I mean, a lot of my success, and of course it's a process still, goes to my alma mater.
Okay, so I mean, as you have a diverse experience and you have been working into different organizations and you've been around, I mean, in different countries, in different universities, so what one thing you would like to change in our education system?
So basically, at the undergraduate and graduate level, it's very similar, you know, the instruction style, the assignment and the projects, but I would recommend more practicality of it. For example, at Cornell, they sent us to field, they sent us to work with different organizations, and we worked as we are consultants.
So you actually went to different countries through Cornell?
Yes,
okay. I mean. So Maira, this was totally about your education and your experiences. So what about, I mean, your UCP's memory? Are you fond of any memory or anything which you still remember and you want to relive it?
I do remember, you know, a lot of things. For example, there was this, you know, there used to be a lot of events that I missed, you know, at that time, because of course, you know, you're not independent, you know, you are dependent on your parents too, you know, for your time management and for, you know, your work-life balance. So now when I'm independent, so I feel like, oh, I missed so many events, you know, I missed so many concerts, and it's not like it's a waste of time, but I believe it's like networking is so important. So if I go back to that time, I would attend all those events, you know, and probably I would have met you, Ali, you know, in ushers. So I missed that time a lot. So I think I would have done better in that. But besides, the one thing I miss the most is my professors. And unfortunately, none of them are here at the UCP. Oh. So that is, you know, I really want to reconnect with my professors and, you know, want to take their feedback, you know. So this is how you made me. And what do you suggest? Like, you know, all those things, I just want to speak to them.
Your whole journey, Maira, it was really inspiring for the youngsters, for our students, and it was really, you know, learning experience for me as well to know about your journey. So Maira, in the end, would you like to give any advice or any any piece of your, share your experience with the young students who are really looking forward to go abroad or to become successful in Pakistan?
Sure, Ali. So to the current students, I would like to tell you, please set high academic and professional goals for yourself. Not only professional, but personal too. Connect with more students, with your teachers, with professional agencies, and learn from their experience. And do not worry about failures. Take risks, because failure is just an event. But success is not an event, it's a process. So keep moving forward to that and feel motivated by amazing people around you and their stories. Not all the people are successful, you know. Your definition of success is different from theirs. So everybody has their own journey towards where they want to be. So keep moving forward and never look back. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Maira. So if you want to become part of this Alumni Success Story Show replug, you can register yourself with Alumni Relations Office, UCP. Thank you very much.